Hi, hello my dears and darlings of YTV. You're watching the South India's one of the coolest show at a celeb talk, and my name is Prashant. Today we have the fresh, young, energetic, and he is well recognized as a Cadburys of sandalwood industry. He is none other than DharmaKeerthiRaj. So hi Dharma, how are you?
Hello, I'm good, how are you?
I'm fine too, thank you so much. And again, so you're well recognized as a Cadburys. So, what do you feel? Do you like that title?
Actually, that title has come from Darshan. Actually, when I was shooting for Navagraha, so he came up with that. There's a dialogue called "Hey Cadburys." So it comes from his mouth. So from there, people started like being like, "Oh, Cadburys." And in the climax, also he uses that word.
Okay.
So from there, people started branding me as like Cadburys and this one. But right now I'm like trying on that image changeover.
Okay.
So let's see.
Okay, so you're trying for image changeover, is it?
Image changeover in the sense, not like a complete, see people like me as a chocolate boy, as a lover boy. But I thought as a variety, in cinemas you need some kind of a variety.
Okay.
So I was thinking, okay fine, like now I've showed a journey of where I've been a lover boy, in Mumtaz, in Ole Visma. So now in my next movies, I'm like trying something like a mass kind of appeal or something.
That's really cool, and directors might be watching, and who likes to get you as an action star, they will be approaching you.
Hopefully it happens.
Okay, that's really cool. Again, what's your first memory of movies?
First memory when I got into movies, the first thing when I got this offer, it was very special to me.
Okay.
Because I was just at gym. So I just finished gym and I was like, my mom called and said, Darshan and Dinakar sir is coming home. I was like, okay, probably they're coming to give some invitation or some kind of an invite for some function or something. And as soon as they came, they were like, they told my dad, uncle, we need your son as a hero in our movie. And we were like, what? Okay. And like, no, seven villain sons, we're doing this movie, so we need your son as a... My dad said, superb, it's a lovely concept and no second thought at all.
Okay.
So that was one memory before shooting started.
Okay.
So on sets when I went, I didn't know anything because I was just... I was so-and-so Keerthiraj's son, but I never was not inclined, okay, I'm going to get into, like I was just studying and I was into sports, I was a national tennis player. So I was into those things. I never thought, okay, wholeheartedly I'll get into movies. So all of a sudden it happened, and then when I went on set, it was like not like a well-prepared kind of a guy or something. But Dinakar, sir, the director, was just been superb and fantastic. He was like, every bit, he just taught me like every small thing of it. So their memory was like the first shot, it was like a lengthy 4-5 lines dialogue, and I did it, and then he was like very happy, and that was a good memory. And shooting with
was you them. Not excited when you got that offer?
I was very excited and nervous too, because it's not easy facing Darshan with that voice and that height and that look, and when he looks into your eyes, and I'm like, okay fine. And I was like this little thin and not experienced kind of this one. So it was good, fantastic memories. We had a lovely time shooting for that movie. You had a beautiful time.
That's really great. And again, when I just talk about your dad, he is an awesome and fabulous actor. We can't compare him with some other actors. He has his unique style and he is very different, Mr. Keerthiraj.
Yeah.
So, is that thing made you to get into acting?
No, actually when I used to go with him, like when I used to, like when we used to go for any, like a kind of a function or an audio release or something, I was not into industry. But when I used to go with him, I used to like that attention.
Okay.
Somewhere people coming, taking a photograph and just speaking to him and taking his autograph or something that, and as soon as you enter a function, chuck, 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 all those, all those limelighting. So there, me and my mom and my sister always used to stay back. Me and my dad always used to, I always used to go with him.
Okay.
So I used to enjoy that limelight, like, okay, it's a nice. But then I thought, okay, let's see. After
so you
studies,
started experiencing that.
Yeah,
the people coming, approaching, and having those autographs. And
definitely. I liked it. I liked that kind of this one attention. I liked it. Yeah.
That's really good. So again, you like people commenting on you, or do you really encourage it?
See, commenting, we can take it as both as a positive and negative kind of this one. Like when people say good about you, you need to be like, okay, thank you, kinds. But when people say bad, you should analyze why they're saying.
Yeah.
And when I say bad, it might be like with regard to your acting, or with regard to your career, or with regard to meeting a group of people, talking, your humbleness, or the way you carry yourself. It might be anything.
Yeah.
So when people point out on something, you shouldn't be like, oh, how can he say that?
Okay.
You should be like, okay, why do you say that?
Yes.
Why? I mean, when he's not mad to just come and say, hey, you're
exactly
not thing.
Yes.
I mean, there will be something. you can take it as a positive thing and then try to rectify it and say, yeah, correct, what he said was right.
And start working
yeah,
on that.
Like that's what he said was right, correct. If you can take it like, so you need to your dance, your fights or something, you need to change your expression and change your this one and look, you need to get your body. You'll be like, okay, fine, that is something your audience is giving a suggestion. It might be from the family, within the family, or friends or anybody. But something unrelated, like just come and say random things which is not related to you, that you can just take it from one year and leave it. I mean that, because the many people will talk many things.
Yeah.
But
we can't impress everybody. Yeah.
Not impress everybody, but how far you can take it like a positive kind of a thing is what I feel is good.
Okay. That's really cool. And again, when it comes to fitness, see, as an actor, there's certain challenges to be faced, you know. Fitness is a part of it.
Correct.
So how do you manage with your daily routine?
See, fitness, I think when I speak about fitness, I think my major inspiration is my dad.
Mm-hmm.
Because from childhood, we've been brought up like very normal kind of, you know, been brought up like we're so-and-so's son or something, or daughter, or my sister, nothing.
Okay.
Normal school van, normal auto, normal bus, everything, but in a nice way they brought us up. And when it comes to fitness, he always used to take us during holidays or during every Saturday, Sundays for his badminton, tennis, or skating or something, because he was regularly into it.
Okay.
How many movies he's doing, whatever he's doing, 6 o'clock he used to get up in the morning, go 1 hour, play shuttle or tennis, come back, then get ready, then head to this one. I think that time gym was not much of this one for him. He was more into those lines of natural kind of a fitness kind of a thing. So that turned me also into like a kind of being with him, you know, through all these years. It started like, it's not like people, they don't need to push me. And I have the tendency and that thing of my dad's genetic, you say, that I don't put on, like, I have a good metabolism. If I eat, how much I eat, biryani, chicken, whatever I eat. But I tend to digest fast. And I've taken over his, this one, like,
suggestions.
Whatever it is, ups and downs. Because, see, our industry, it's not like a steady thing. When you're, like, when you're working, you're like, it's not like a 9-to-6 job, Monday to Saturday, and then you have your Saturday, Sunday family time. It's not like, suddenly you're 15 days, you're busy. Suddenly 1 month, you're going to be without work.
Yeah.
So it's like, in that portion, how you keep yourself fit is very important. I think gym and a sport, like probably in Saturday, Sundays, I go play tennis.
Mm-hmm.
Weekly, twice, sometimes I'm free, or if I'm not shooting, I go for dance class.
Okay.
But regular gym, weekly, 5 days, gym. For fitness, it's not like, because see, every time to have a beautiful body, to have a six-pack is impossible.
You cannot.
You can just speak up. Like when you have something coming, okay, you have a project in 2 months, then you can get ready and thing, and then you need to show it, and then maintain. You always can't say, oh, you need to look huge or anything. But I believe eat healthy, eat nicely, work out.
Okay.
Have a strict regime on workout, eat healthy, because too much of dieting also depresses you.
Yes.
But when you have to diet at a particular point, like when you're a peak time, then you diet. But otherwise, eat healthy and work out healthy. That's what I feel is like a good...
That's really cool. And again, as you told, there's lots of ups and downs. Have you ever faced those hurdles? Would you like to share anything? Any hurdles you faced ever?
See, definitely I have, because when people look at it, frankly speaking, when everybody says the tag is there, Keerthi Raj, so it's Dharma Keerthi Raj. So what everybody thinks, it's like, oh, his father's this one is there. But I never took undue advantage of it, of so my dad's name and misusing it, or not. One day I got a Navagraha, I must have got an offer because 7 villain sons, so I was one of the villain sons. So I needed to do this one, so they took me.
Okay.
But it cannot be like, I've got complete movies because I'm so-and-so son.
Yes.
My dad has told me, you prove, you work hard. That's when everything will change. Nothing is going to change until unless like you don't prove.
Okay.
So he's like always, and definitely there is ups and downs, because might be in terms of it's financially or even recognition or this one, because they've brought us up, my parents have brought us up without any, like, with no hurdles, like good school, good schooling.
Yes.
Before I even passed.
No, when you compare, not your childhood, maybe when you started your journey.
Uh-huh.
At that
time. Even that time, he's been very supportive, because initial days, I didn't see any money. And then every son has this one. He has to return something to his parents for what they've done for us for some years.
Yes.
So that took a real struggle for me, because for me to really earn and look after my dad's little expenses, or...
And also you love to keep up that name Keerthi Raj as
keep up that name. And I mean, he's not got everything easy. He's worked for it.
Yes.
He's worked for his own house. He's worked for his living. He's worked for his car. So somewhere as a son, even I need to just give back somewhere, support them. How long can he be doing it? So that's when even I started feeling, yes, I mean, and that really is a pressure. It's not easy. See, if it had been like a huge crorepati kind of person, that is different.
Then that is different. That is different.
But in his days, money per day and all was very less.
Yeah.
But what thing he's achieved, what he has to achieve and what he has done for us, nothing less.
Okay.
But somewhere when I feel he should be more happy.
Yeah.
I want to see my dad and mom more happy. I want to see them, like, for what they have done, I want to give double. So that's the time when I feel like there's a lot of pressure, movies and this one, financially. So it's still a struggling phase. Still, I mean, see, once you make a mark, see, there's no end to it actually.
Okay.
Now I might be saying, okay, one hit, then life will change.
Yeah.
Once I get one hit, I'll be like, okay, fine, I need another. So it's a never-ending journey. So nobody is like, a man is like satisfied with what he has. I think it's very rare to find such people.
Okay.
But I mean, I've been on that, I've seen both the sides of it, ups and downs. So now even if success comes, I don't think that's going to hit my head very hard.
Yeah.
And I don't think I'm going to be like, oh my God, kind of. So I mean, okay. I'm going to take it very
You're already in the track of success.
No, no, I mean, there's still a lot of struggle. I mean, frankly speaking, it is still, I mean, people recognize me and this one. But as an actor, I still
need that break.
I need that break. I have a lot to prove. And there's no end.
Mm-hmm.
Not that in one movie now, if I go dance well or fight well, that's not the end.
That's right.
There are many people today, like if you see Shivarna.
Yeah. Yes.
Even today, if you see him, he's like, he goes, like at that age also, he's like, the day goes on the set, he's like so humble, so down to earth, so energetic.
Yes.
You can't even just say he's 50, 52. I mean, we get a complex. Like,
yes.
Like,
he dances
so well. He acts and his energy. 9 to 6, he's like, everybody is like on their feet because he's there around.
Okay.
So that we should take those things as an inspiration.
Okay.
We're just too small still. I'm just too small.
So Shivanna is your inspiration, is it?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, many people are there. I mean, when you see even Apu sir or Darshan sir,
yes,
Sudeep sir, everybody, the way they work,
mm-hmm,
I've seen their working style.
Yeah.
It's like very nice. I mean, very good. When I was doing Mumtaz, when I was doing a song, Yash was doing Mr. and Mrs. Ramachandran.
Yes.
And he was a big hero at that time. That time also I saw him, 7:30 he was on set.
Is it? Okay.
7:30 Yash was on set, he was like half an hour rehearsal, then 8:30 he was like doing his job.
Okay.
So that's all of them, nobody has come up in a very easy way.
Yes, everybody
is struggling, everybody is like giving the best and everybody wants to be the best. And so these are the people we take as an inspiration.
Okay.
Like, okay, we should learn certain things from, you can pick and think from. Yeah.
There's nothing particular allowed to be inspired by someone.
You can pick every, I mean, every person has a different thing.
Yes.
Like when I meet Apu sir Puneet, he's like one of the most, he's also one of the most down-to-earth persons. Like I spent so much time with Darshan, even he's one of the most down-to-earth persons, or anybody for that matter. I mean, the way they talk, the way they're humble. So I think all, you can pick from one person, you can learn. It's only not about going and acting.
Yes.
It's not only
exactly.
Your first basic thing is like your sincerity, hard work, dedication. I think these three are the first thing.
Okay, again, Dharma, what happens, you know, sometimes your weakness may turn into strength also. In the situation, in few situations, have you ever faced that kind of weakness turned into strength?
Yeah, there is a lot. I mean, because when I say weakness, initially I didn't know how to carry myself on sets or something, or like, there was some negative kind of this one like was happening to me.
As of?
I mean, when it comes to in terms of acting or when it comes to terms of any, I mean, small things, anything.
Okay.
So then I started realizing that I need some changes.
Okay.
I need some changes in me. I need some changes. I started working on it.
Okay.
And certain things that happened on sets also made me into a positive person.
Okay.
It made me come back home, think and say, why?
Uh-huh.
Why did this happen? For what?
Okay.
Change yourself.
Mm-hmm.
That's how I changed many things.
Okay.
Changed in that. And now I can see, I mean, certain changes and good. It's a good feeling.
Really good. Yeah. Okay. And again, what exactly DharmaKeerthiraj? Are you romantic or are you arrogant? How is it?
See, I mean, it's not about praising myself or anything, but I...
No, it's not praising, it's just describe yourself.
Describe myself is like, first thing is being humble.
Okay.
Hardworking.
Okay.
And I think the root cause is from where you come from. I
mean, okay.
The upbringing also.
Okay.
So I think humble and hard work.
Okay.
Humble and hardworking.
Mm-hmm.
Believe in that and then...
Mm-hmm. So you're not romantic, is it?
I am quite romantic.
Oh, is it?
That you should... Yeah.
Okay, have you romanced anybody?
On screen.
Off screen.
Off screen.
Yeah.
I've had, I mean, I won't say like serious love affairs or anything, but yeah, general crush, anybody for that matter. I mean,
okay. No, I'm not talking about crush. The romance you had done.
The romance? I mean, just proposing to a girl.
Okay.
Met you and
okay.
It's very like a destination kind of a place.
Okay.
Like a dinner place, going down my knees, yeah. Being romantic. Yeah. So
you still miss those days?
Yeah, they're fantastic. They're lovely time. You don't do it now, but that was nice. I mean,
okay.
We used to talk, we'll get married and all, but today she's happy in her own way. And
she is. Okay.
In her own way, so.
Okay.
So that's one or two things in life that has happened and it's
okay.
Nice.
Okay, that's really cool. Again, what is the one image you want to deliver to the society or for the to your followers or the fans, anything like that?
Image as in, I want to be known as a good actor,
okay.
I mean, a good human being basically first.
Okay.
People should be like, okay, fine, more than anything, success and flops are like come secondary.
Yeah.
But being a good human being a good son to your
parents, yeah,
and being a good person to your family, being a good person to your friends, being a good person to people who come, like fans who approach you,
uh-huh.
The people who come to speak to you, be humble to them, be nice to them,
mm-hmm.
Be nice to everybody. Try in your movies to give somewhere some message in society. Not every movie is easy to give a message in society. Mm-hmm. Try not to give anything negative to the public, to the mm-hmm. people. Try to give some positive thoughts or positive notes to people. And yeah, that's it.
That's really cool. And what is your status now? Are you still bachelor? Most of the girls might be seeing this program.
Like
you look really
bachelor,
good.
Eligible bachelor, I look like I'm married with one.
No, not married. I'm talking about your status when you're committed or still bachelor. It's
no,
like
I'm
that.
Still a bachelor.
Okay.
So still.
So girls, you can just make a note this point. Like DharmaKeerthiraj is still a bachelor guy. So applications are also opened. Open?
I mean, I don't know because right now in my, frankly speaking, just in my peak struggling phase.
Okay.
So right now I think career is my top.
You can take the applications at least, then shortlist it later, no?
I mean they'll look at it, no? I mean, they won't be like, okay, let him achieve something in his life, then we'll
okay.
Then it's the time to fall in love with him, okay. But I don't think. So, mm-hmm. I mean, that's not a priority right now. So probably movies.
Okay. That's really good. And again, what is the one craziest thing you ever faced it? In the film industry or in your personal life, whatever. The craziest stuff.
Which I faced.
Yes.
I mean, certain things, I have this little claustrophobic kind of for this one.
Mm-hmm.
Like I can't get into these caves and all that where it's fully closed.
Okay.
So there I'm a little bit of like that, I get that breathing. I mean, it's not, I know what that is, but there, but I was supposed to do it in Joy Guda, the movie.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So there's one place where I just couldn't do it and I was like feeling like, oh my God, I can jump, I can fight,
okay.
I can dance, I can shoot the whole night or day and night. But why I cannot do that, and somehow we have to just keep on dupe and do it or something. So that is one challenge and one difficulty kind of for this one onset sort of faced. And the craziest kind of a moment, like which I didn't enjoy much. I was like, oh my God, I don't like this kind of a thing. The craziest thing, other than that, craziest thing I've done is like a lot of things. I mean, I'm too passionate about cars and bikes.
Okay.
So I take my bike and ride from here to Goa. Okay. Go on rides from here to Goa.
Okay.
Chikmagalur.
What's your favorite bike?
Oh, I mean,
many.
Not many.
Okay.
Depends even on the money. Okay. So, I mean, yeah.
Which
I mean,
was a bike? It was being gifted
actually
by
now,
your dad.
My first bike was before I got my second PSC results.
Mm-hmm.
I told him, once I pass, then you buy me. He said, no, if I have to wait for all that, it might take time. So,
okay.
Before all that, he just bought me a Pulsar 180.
Oh, that's great.
A beautiful bike.
Mm-hmm.
And then,
you still have it?
No, I don't have that bike.
Okay.
And then, but before that was a CBZ.
Okay.
And before that was a Heropuk, was my first showroom Heropuk, that 3G
okay.
gear.
Okay.
Which I bought, that one.
Mm-hmm.
And then my first car when I was doing Navagraha, which I bought, was a Zen.
Mm-hmm.
7002. It's one of my, until today I miss that car. Like, mm-hmm. A beautiful car. And then good, nice. There's nice memories. But now, probably now, I mean, I like these kind of a cruiser, kind of a this one, bikes. And,
okay.
And this Kawasaki Z800,
okay.
And so probably might pick up one this year, sometime this year.
Okay, what is one mantra you always apply for success?
The only thing I feel is you cannot define success, you cannot see, oh, I'm going to go there, I'm going to become like this, I'm going to become so big.
Mm-hmm.
You should dream, every person
has a dream.
Has to dream.
Yes.
See, the day you stop dreaming, you think just
the
comes
world
down.
Ends actually.
I mean,
yeah?
If you just, okay, I have this, I know.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Being, you shouldn't be that also.
Mm-hmm.
And you shouldn't aim like, oh, I want to fly on jet. I want to own one jet. Not
okay.
that. I'm not saying dreams in that way.
Okay.
In your path, whatever your dreams is, okay, today I'm doing two movies, probably another two movies, probably something nice in those movies. something probably, okay, today I'm driving so-and-so car. Probably after 2-3 movies, after 1 year, probably if I can own this car. Okay, I have a 2-bedroom flat.
Okay.
Probably if I can buy a 3-bedroom flat.
You just suggest people to go step by step.
Step by step. It's just climbing the ladder step by step, but you have to have something.
Yes.
So I think success is you have to dream and work hard. It's not only a sitting and dreaming.
Dreaming, yeah.
Dream towards it and work hard towards it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, try and work as hard as you can.
Mm-hmm.
And then leave rest to God and to the Almighty, your parents' blessings. I think all those do come.
Okay, what do you want to say to the people who always believe on luck and they don't work anything?
I don't think everybody, nobody, I don't think many.
Most of them, they just say that if luck is there, yeah.
No, I mean, in our industry also, I feel somewhere, certain factor of luck is required.
Important.
Very important.
Okay.
Very, very important because, see, I might work too hard.
Yeah.
And the director's, the story might not be good or the music. Or the director might be really good. The producer might be really good. But somewhere I would have faltered.
Yeah, okay.
So somewhere everything has to come together and there should be one factor of luck where people accept it and there's a hit. And in our industry, definitely luck factor plays a lot of...
Yes, it does.
It does. But again, I'm saying it's like hard work with luck.
Okay.
I think 90% is hard work.
Mm-hmm.
10%, yes, a good team, luck, everything does help.
That's
but
good.
Everybody, not only in the film industry, but even if you're in the software or even if you're in this one, have certain dreams like... Don't say, okay, I'm just sitting here doing my software, 9-to-6 job, I go back. Try to expand beyond that.
Mm-hmm.
On a Saturday, Sunday, if you can do something else.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Like an extracurricular activity or something,
exactly.
Something small.
Okay.
Let not be big.
So you suggest people to have an option?
Yeah, you should. It's not only about just 9-to-6, Monday to Friday, sit, and then Saturday, Sunday, chill out. No, something to add on to it.
Mm-hmm.
Something, anything small, anything. It doesn't need to be big.
Mm-hmm.
Small things become big, yeah.
So you want to work for rewards or the awards?
See, awards is not in our hands.
No, some people will be like...
Rewards, yeah, definitely, because I will not say I'm like, oh, I don't need money or I don't think... I mean, that's... I mean, to survive today,
at the end of the day,
we need. I mean, you work hard for
it.
You definitely need that money. But awards is something where you can work hard on sets, but again, there is some panel or a jury or something, or people. This one who accepts you. Like how you are, what have you performed, everything. But awards is not in our hands. We cannot go and say, oh, give me
just
this award.
Please award me.
Yeah. It all depends on the people.
Okay.
And perform. You perform there, probably people accept it and the jury or whatever is there.
That's
but reward, definitely. Everybody works for that three time meal and
Okay, again, so what is the one thing that the world doesn't know about?
The world doesn't know about?
You.
Probably I think I'm quite a shy person.
Okay.
I'm pretty shy.
The world doesn't know that you're shy, is it? You pretend as if you're not shy.
I am shy, especially initially I used to be very shy. Especially in college and school.
I don't believe this, you know what? You are romantic and you're shy, is it?
No, I'm quite shy. Like I have to face a group of people or big crowd
like that.
Or something like that. Not that I don't know that context or anything, but somewhere I'm little on that shy nature, like little. But now, slowly, trying to change that and open up. And
okay.
I'm not, I cannot approach people, like even if a heroine, the first day on set, probably I'll take a couple of days.
Couple of days you?
Yeah, I mean, initially thought it was very bad. When I was like working with Navagraha with Sharmila Vandre, it was a very nice experience when we were doing that song.
Yeah.
I was supposed to hold her like this.
Yeah.
I literally like, I was like,
not
okay, I'm sitting behind, I'm going to hold you now, okay?
Okay.
She's like, Dharma, you're doing a movie, so it's okay.
That's cool.
So I literally took her permission. I was so shy. I mean, I was like so shy, nervous, and I mean, she's helped me a lot. I mean, initially in this one, and Mumtaz, we're more comfortable.
Okay.
She made me more comfortable when I did that second movie, Mumtaz. I mean, but initially, I was like very, very like few scenes, then that song and all that. It was like a thing, but it's good, nice experience.
Any of your decisions, you regret taking those decisions till now?
Somewhere I felt after Navagraha.
Mm-hmm.
I felt somewhere I didn't take the right path after that.
Okay.
I'm not comparing the movies what I did. I did Valaya Smaya, fantastic. The producers invested on me.
Yeah.
And things didn't go that well, but the songs were a hit. Mumtaz also, things didn't go well, but songs became a hit.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
And when I didn't have anything, they came to me, approached me, and they did a movie. So hats off to them. I'm very grateful to them. But immediately after Navagraha, I think 2-3 years, I just sat without doing anything.
Okay.
Somewhere, even after Valaya Smaya, 1 year I wasted, I was thinking, what next? I think I didn't get into the right direction.
Because you have such a good French background and all. Okay, they didn't suggest you anything.
See, people suggest, but you should be ready to take up certain decisions in your life.
Yes.
And that's happened from past 2 years. Things have changed, God's grace, slowly.
Okay.
Not think, at least step by step, as I said, climbing the ladder and just trying and it's going.
That's really good. And again, if I give that opportunity to have a cup of coffee, whom do you prefer?
I mean, as a hero or...
Heroine. Yeah.
Bollywood, sandalwood or...
Any, yaar. As you like.
There's so many people, actually.
Only one.
Actually, initial days, when I was getting like Darshan and Rakshita's combination was a very big hit.
Uh-huh.
The Sutra Gadi Aya and all that, and I used to watch the song better. So I think that time I was like a big fan of Darshan and Rakshita. I mean, fan in the sense like I used to watch their songs like crazy.
They were a superb pair, in fact. Yes.
That time and coffee with heroine, no?
Heroine, yeah.
Heroine. Okay.
Don't you be feel bad that having coffee with the hero?
I think if you see that, I think I like Tamanna.
Tamanna? Why? That's because she has a milky beauty.
Isn't huh?
I don't know what a milky beauty is.
Okay.
But her smile and her thing, and that song, that Paya one movie.
Yen
Kadal Sonna Neramile.
Can you song? Okay, sorry. Can you just sing?
I mean, I'm not too good in singing.
Okay.
Yen Kadal Sonna Neramile in that song. And somehow, she's nice. I like her. And there are many talented ones in Kanada, I mean, talented heroines in Canada also.
Yeah.
Who I'd love to work with.
Yes.
I mean, hopefully God gives me a chance. There's so many people. I mean, I cannot name one or two because I believe more than bringing someone else from different places and making them do a Kanada film, I think we have lovely people over here, lovely heroines who are like really working hard to make it big and who are, many people are making it big, big also. Like you see, like if you see Rachita Ram, Shruti Harihara and Ragini, Meghna Sundaraj, I mean, and so many, I mean, sorry if I've left out your names, but many, Deepa Sanidhi, all Kannadi guys.
They are like all very different from each other too.
All Kannadi guys who like, they want to make a mark and they're like, Haripriya, all very good talent, I mean, they're really talented.
Okay.
I look at them, very talented, Sindhu Loknath and... so many Aditi
but Akira. You're very clever, I'll tell you.
I'm trying not to leave out anybody.
That's why I told you you're very clever. So you want to...
I'm working with two new heroines, Nikita and Archana.
Okay.
They're also very good.
Okay.
I mean, they're also trying to make a mark. Mm-hmm. Nikita is working with Ganesh in a new movie. So after Joy Gooda with me. So like very good talents we have over here. So good.
Okay, again, 5 years from now, how do you want to be portrayed by people? After 5 years?
People should be like, okay, he's must have climbed the ladder slowly, but he's achieved something in his life.
Yeah.
And even the day we saw him, 5 years back, when we meet him and when we spoke to him, 5 years down the line, even after success, and God, if God's willing, I get good success, 5 years down the line.
Obviously, you deserve it, you'll get it
hopefully,
too. Yeah.
5 years down the line, if I get that, people should be like, oh my God, when you spoke to him, 5 years back also, he wasn't so nice. Now he's like speaking so sweetly and he's like really humble and he's like achieved something in his life. So that's how I want people to look at me and recognize me, even not only in 5 years, throughout my life, I mean in the career in Kannada industry.
Okay, what is the contribution you want to give it to the society?
See, society, what I believe in is not every time you need to go to a particular orphanage or to a particular place.
Yeah.
To donate your money or to do something. You should. I mean, that should, fine, on a birthday or something. Like
yes, yes.
Probably when I do it, I would not like to mention where, how, when.
Okay.
But...
you have the habit, you do it.
Yeah, I mean, we do it in very small way. Whatever I can afford, whatever I can do in a small way, I do it. But I feel more than that, if you can help the needy, like around you.
Okay.
Like probably you have a driver. Your driver's son is doing his education, he's doing his 10th.
Yes.
He needs something.
Yes.
Or you have a friend, or you have some driver or an instructor.
We can find so many around us.
Like an example, like my mom instructor, his wife was a sugar patient.
Mm-hmm.
So she was carrying.
Okay.
So there's monthly kind of for this one, medicines that they need to do. So somewhere, small things, whatever you can do. It's not only going, doing it, showing it, and telling people.
Focusing it.
It's not that. I think if you can do small things around you.
Yeah, we can find many.
Around you, small things. When you find some... Some people say, oh, why should we give her 10 rupees? She can go work on the road if you find some lady. 10 rupees, we use it in so many ways.
Yes, exactly.
We just burn it also.
Okay. That's really very nice idea.
15 bucks for one cigarette, you just finish it and 15 bucks is just gone down. If you can, just do it and forget it there.
Okay.
And certain things you shouldn't expect. Somebody calls you and tells you, I need 5,000.
Mm-hmm.
If you cannot give 5,000, give 2,000.
Yeah.
And say you do one thing, you keep this initially, you start off, do something.
Yeah.
You okay, go clear.
And they'll be getting the
track. And then you just give that 2,000 and then forget it.
Okay. Yeah. So it's
the
like
more
that.
You expect, like, oh, you did something, you gave him 2,000, oh, you didn't, then it's going to be like a...
Yes.
I'm not saying give everything and forget anything. There should be vice versa kind of thing, where you can help and this. But some places when the person is in real needy, I mean, you know he cannot give it back. If he promises also, like, in 1 week I'll give it to you. If he is not able to give it, just forget it.
Okay.
Like, small things. If you can afford it, you can.
Yeah, that's really good. And finally, what do you want to say about your future projects or ideas? What do you have?
Right now I'm working on Chanaksha.
Okay.
And Joy Guda. Those two projects are like in completion.
Okay.
And then probably next we are planning a horror movie. I'm planning a horror movie.
Mm-hmm.
So a different genre kind of a thing, a horror script.
Okay.
So if that comes through, I'll be working on that. And then there's a bank robbery kind of a this one, like a black money.
Okay.
Like a bank robbery.
It's quite experimental.
Yeah,
stuff.
That one on a bank robbery kind of this one. So, and
any plans to direct?
No, as of now.
No.
I have a lot to learn.
There's
a lot to learn. Direction is something you cannot just stylishly get up and say, oh, I want to direct and keep on co-direct and say, I might have ideas of when I go on sets, like how to think. But that doesn't mean I know direction.
Yes.
Direction, we need to respect the directors that have come in industry.
Exactly.
They have worked for it.
Yeah.
And I cannot just say, oh, sir, nane barthin, I'll direct.
Yeah.
That's the thing. Probably once I learn, probably once I get to that level of learning in this one, and probably if I
any plans to have your own production house? Starting
up. No.
Not as of now, no.
Definitely, as of now, no. I think
you don't. Why? Okay.
We are very contented people.
Okay.
Been brought up like that, and father has gone through a lot of hardships. So,
no.
Just see happy days, good days.
Okay.
More than doing productions, as I told you, if I can do something, I won't say society and this one. I'm going to do that. No, I won't promise anything that.
Okay.
But whatever I can do for my side, small things or big things, if God gives me that real.
Mm-hmm.
That real strength to do it, I will do whatever I can from my side to help people. Probably if I cannot produce, probably if people who are struggling, who want to become aspiring actors or actresses or friend characters or comedians, I think whatever I can do from my side,
you're gonna
try to encourage people
that,
and recommend people and to do something. And that's all I can do for my side.
That's really good. And finally, what do you want to tell about YTV and the viewers?
YTV, firstly, you've been fantastic. You started off from 2010. And it's been a brilliant channel.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. And my first interview with YTV, so it's a very nice feeling. And please support YTV, and my support, my wishes is always there, YTV. And in turn, I want your wishes and support and love for me to grow in this industry. So thank you, YTV, and all the best to all the viewers who are watching. And hope I spoke good. And
yes,
hope you'll enjoy my talks. And work hard. My mantra is work hard, sincerity, dedication, hard work.
Yeah.
Be good to your parents, love your parents, look after your parents, look after your siblings. If you're married, look after your husband, wife, whatever. I think immediate first thing, your best friends or whatever. Be good to everybody, and I think that's the main motto of life.
Yes.
I think then comes money, then comes success, then comes growing to big heights. But I think these are basic things. So this is what I've learned from my dad and what I'm following. So. That's what I'd like to share with you.
Thank you so much for being on show, and you deserve
you so
to be a superstar
soon.
Thank you. And I'll be meeting you.
Yeah. Sure.
thank you so much. Okay, viewers, my dears and darlings, today I'm going to end up and wind up the show. That's because it's time to wind up. And again, I'll be meeting you soon with some other celebrity in Celeb Talk. Till then, keep watching YTV. It's your channel.